I watched Sseth's Rimworld video. I'm trying to remember when I played Rimworld, what happened. I mean, I kinda died, but I don't remember what happened. Did I play on a hard difficulty? You picked random Randy, and that was hard, right? Random but not hard. But anything can happen from the start. Wait, so with that difficulty, can good stuff happen to you and bad stuff happen to you completely random? It's not just random like meteors and fires and shit. Ah, okay. I didn't think that the game was too bad, but I wasn't used to that kind of game. I don't know, I haven't played too many building colony games. Sseth review explains it all. Okay, we'll watch one Sseth review, Rim Job World.
Hey, hey, people. Sseth here. Today, I'll be reviewing Rimworld, because it hit 1.0 recently, and it's pretty fucking great. It's made by a few people.
Did I play during 1.0? China,
including this guy, who wants you to buy his book. Rimworld is a sci-fi colony simulation game, which includes, but is not limited to,
no.
Forceful organ harvesting, cannibalism, catching carcinomas from breathing in toxic fallout, and cargo pods falling from the sky directly on your favorite animal. Rimworld's got it all. It's very similar in the vein of Dwarf Fortress. You generate a planet, you choose some appropriate colonists, which could either be useful members of society possessing skills that will improve your chances of survival, or mentally challenged apes who can't actually contribute anything meaningful to your colony besides being a walking, breathing, shitting sack of human meat. And then once you've chosen them, you crash land on a location of your choice. The location of your choice could be a reasonable one, like a forest with appropriate vegetation and close proximity to friendly colonies, or you could land in the middle of Malaria Town, or maybe you'd like to spice things up and crash in a sub-zero ice sheet or a scorching
AI
hot desert
based?
With no resources. Why would you ever possibly do that? Because it's fun. Your ultimate goal? Get yourself a working ship and get the fuck off this planet. But surviving that long and managing the combined autism of multiple colonists who think beating the shit out of each other just prior to a pirate raid is a good idea will make that exceedingly difficult. When starting a new game, Rimworld asks you to choose from a selection of three different AI storytellers. These influence the events and the frequency at which they occur as part of your colony's story. In no particular order, they are Cassandra Classic, who will progressively increase the challenge your colony experiences by sending a pack of alpha beavers to eat all your trees 5 times in a row. There's also Phoebe Chillax, who suffers from bipolar disorder. She does absolutely nothing for several months, making you question whether or not the game is broken. Then she'll send 2 hordes of pirates with sappers who will dig for your defenses while all of your colonists simultaneously catch intestinal parasites from not wearing appropriate protection when eating ass. And then there's Randy Random. Randy doesn't hide the fact that he's out for your blood and doesn't actually give a shit what happens to your colony.
I played
Events
on this
will happen, good or bad, but they'll happen consistently. Randy has previously sent raids, crashed mechanoid ships containing toxic waste, and started a volcanic winter. All in the span of a single afternoon, but he made up for it shortly after by instantly domesticating every squirrel on the map to join my colony and eat my potatoes. Objectively, Randy is the best storyteller. He follows no set patterns and keeps you guessing and adapting your strategy, whereas Phoebe lulls you into a false sense of security, and Cassandra can go fuck herself. The game is quite innovative in the sense that each colonist has their own background, traits, and personality. This sounds good in theory. If you've worked in a special needs school before and have experience of tard wrangling, you'll find yourself right at home. Colonists can have traits ranging anywhere from being kind, hardworking, and having exceptional immunity to being neurotic, depressive, and being a hideously deformed mouth breather. Their backgrounds often mesh together with their traits and create an exceptionally volatile, unstable human being. These are quite diverse and colorful, and consist of both a childhood and an adulthood that forms the core of their character. There's probably so many fucking backgrounds
childhood
that I've never even seen
form.
Them all. You can have research scientists, medieval slaves, Japanese pop idols, PUBG players, workers and vat-grown sex slaves, all living in the same colony. Or you can get a special snowflake who, due to their pampered childhood and traumatic adulthood, can do no useful work and sexually identifies as limestone. I recommend stripping these people nude, handing them some dog food, and sending them out to the wilderness. Don't worry, they'll be fine. Oh shit, she got captured by pirates. Don't worry. Help is on the way. Characters interact with each other, and may even love and hate the shit out of each other. An efficient colony needs a variety of skills and people to survive, as every person shines in different tasks and develops them at different rates according to how much they enjoy it. A digger, seasoned in mining, will feel right at home chipping away iron and exposing my colony to insect infestations, while the sickly 15-year-old boy I bought from a slave trader may not be the optimal person for crafting leather jackets, owing to the fact that I've replaced both his legs and hands with wooden stumps. And you can do that. Every body part can be replaced with prosthetic and bionic parts, because people tend to lose them, whether through a stray bullet or getting pecked out by an ostrich. Accidents happen. Rimworld has a fully functional body part and organ system for every living creature in the game. Parts can get damaged, scarred, burned, infected, and chopped right off. And that's about the gist of it.
The UI is like,
you need to adapt the hard to part about the game, I feel like. Physical threats as you slowly
like, it's not hard
expand.
Once you learn it,
in
but to
threats,
get into.
You can even research new and additional technology, giving you access to equipment, resources, and structures that increase your self-sufficiency. You can also open up the world map and send caravans to trade with friendly colonies, take missions, and improve diplomatic relations. You can even start additional colonies, get ambushed by flesh-eating turtles, build pod launchers, and fire a dozen super soldiers dressed in power armor straight into a colony and commit genocide. Rimworld 1.0 really has it all. Aside from handling food, energy, appropriate accommodations, and clothing, defense is probably your most important priority. No matter how well your colony is doing, an unexpected attack can decimate your entire base. Luckily, the AI is pretty predictable, and even the smarter AI patterns can be learned and manipulated. This leads to people constructing
increasingly elaborate and sadistic kill boxes. I think I will do
another run at one point. Sadistic kill boxes, labyrinthine trap mazes, Romanian corpse freezers, engineered cave-ins, and
I do remember some of the first
ovens. Temperature dynamics work quite nicely in this game, so one of my favorite defensive strategies is to bait.
If I play on the Cassandra one, will she tell me like, you should do this first,
as they
managed
to slowly crawl halfway through the
tunnel. Wait, they did that on Random Randy too.
Edgar Allan Poe on them and seal the entrance behind them. Since we don't want our guests to get cold, I tell one of my colonists to start a nice roaring fire near the exit using some conveniently placed furniture. We seal the door shut, and that's when they make the realization. The walls are covered in scratches. The tunnel heats to several hundred degrees Celsius. Clothing ignites, flesh fries, and skin melts off a bone. Each man will dig and claw at the walls in futile desperation, tearing their nails out while their organs boil. And then Randy will drop a cargo pod containing milk. The best trait, of course, is psychopath. That's a bit of a segue, but I felt that I should talk about my current colony. I exclusively recruit psychopaths because they practice what I call moral relativism, and I practice what some would call an organ harvesting operation, which personally I find to be a very offensive and bigoted term to describe non-consensual organ arbitrage. Why do I do it? Because it's very profitable. A human in Rimworld can provide you with free healthy organs before they need to rest. One of his kidneys, one of his lungs, and a free choice between his liver or heart. My colony makes every attempt to grow smoothly and weed out undesirables who can't adapt to corporate culture. This one didn't dodge so well. At least he'll make a good sofa. It's amazing how quickly this game turns you into a monster. Surprisingly though, every faction loves me. Besides the raiders, even on the frontiers of civilization, you can't escape the unwashed horde of human rights activism. The soundtrack is pretty alright, but Tanan keeps asking me to buy it separately, together with his book. The graphics are pretty clean and simple, and have a certain charm to how minimalistic they are. It's very utilitarian in its appearance, but still very pleasant. To close off, Rimworld is very expansive with its content right now, and can easily consume hours and days of your life. It's very addictive, challenging, and frustrating. I simultaneously give my highest recommendation and a word of caution, since I genuinely believe my blood pressure and cortisol levels sharply rise when playing this game. It's fucking great. And there's always mods to fix all the broken shit. Go play it. Enjoy it. Get two psychic ships crashing in the middle of your base and never touch that retarded shit ever again. Oh, at least Randy sent me more milk. A warm thank you. to the many members of the Merchants Guild, which have been generously funding and bankrolling these videos. You're all truly wonderful. Have a good one.
We'll give it another shot. At a point. I still have to do another try of the permadeath XCOM. I had to look at chat. I can love me remember that very difficult name. Four letters. Nice.